Datasets generally follow the rule that you create the dataset and then you use it in an element. So let's look at the first step in this and let's create a dataset. Select Tools and Datasets, and you can see that I have no datasets defined. This is my CBT workbook, so I don't have anything in here. I will select New and PI Calculation, and the PI Calculation Data dialog box will allow me to configure a PI Calculation dataset. We're going to start with a very simple one. I'm going to call this CDT underscore calcs. Description is optional. You may or may not use it. It's up to you. And then what I need to do down at the bottom is to enter a tag. I'm going to use the tag search dialog box and select my CDT158 tag. Now you will notice that it does put the single quotation mark before and after the tag name. If you were to simply type a tag name in here, you would have to make sure that you had those tick marks or single quotes in there, or the expression or tag name would not be picked up correctly. If you select a stepped plot, that will force ProcessBook to show you the results in a stair-step manner. If you uncheck this, we will interpolate between the values, the calculation results. People usually with calculations like to retain a stepped plot. And the refresh interval is primarily used if you have non-PI data that you're using exclusively. Because we have a PI tag in here, ProcessBook will know to update that as often as it would a regular tag value. Now we come down to interval and sync time. For right now, I'm just going to use a single tag name in the tagger expression. And the interval is used to tell the system how often to do the calculation. And the default is 10 minutes, but you could use 1 hour, you could use 2 hours, you could use 2 minutes, you could use 2 days, whatever interval suits your needs. And combine that with the sync time if you have a specific time in which you want to do the calculation. One of the reasons you might use sync time is that you're basing this calculation on another calculation that runs maybe every hour. And so in that case, you would alter the sync time for this calculation by maybe 1 minute to make sure the other calculation has had time to complete. Or maybe your interval is 1 day and you want the calculation to run at the end of each shift. And so you might set the sync time to something like 7 hours, and the interval would be in 8 hours. So we would run the calculation every 8 hours with the synchronization time of 7 hours after midnight. So we would get the first calculation at 7 a.m. and hours after that, and so or 8 hours and so forth. Or you might have an interval of 1 day and you want to do the calculation every day at midnight, so you'd leave the sync time of 0. And that's all you need to do to create the basic PI calculation data set. At a very minimum, you need a tag, an interval, and a sync time, and the system will perform the standard calculations for you. So I'll click OK for this and close, and in the next segment we'll learn how to use this data set in a dynamic element. To use the data set, we simply invoke one of the dynamic elements on the screen and use the calculation result in that element. I'm going to use the trend object, so I will select draw and trend, and I will draw a trend on the screen not only of my data set, but I'm also going to use the raw tag value. To bring the data set to the dynamic element, you go next to the tag search button and you select the drop down arrow and then PI calculation. This will display to you the available data sets that you have on your system. I have one data set on my system, and when I select that, I can see all the various columns of information that I can select. Now, I only have a tag as my source data. I don't have an expression. So if I selected value, it would simply give me that tag's value every 10 minutes. It's another way of doing sort of a sampling of the data. But I want to use the average, and I'm going to get a 10-minute average of this data, and I'll click OK. And you'll notice that in my tags and plot, instead of having the tag name, it has the dataset name dot average. So that will be what I will trend in this, what I will look at in this trend. I will select the drop down arrow and go back to tag search. My previous search was cached, so I will select my tag. So I now have my average and my raw value. I think I'll change my interval to 1 hour to make it a little clearer on the trend, and I will click OK to bring the trend back. And you can see the raw data values are being displayed, as well as a running 10-minute average. Every 10 minutes I'm calculating a new average for that tag. So you can see at 12:37 I calculated 152. At the next interval, if I mouse over this, at 12:48 I got a value of 159. Actually, that's the value where I moused over. You'd have to, it will remain constant over that 10-minute period until the data changes. So you can see that the result of those calculations. Now you can use the trend, or you can use the bar graph, or you can use the dynamic value. Any of the standard elements in ProcessBook will display the results of calculation data sets.